Welcome to ECG class number 2. Now I am going to discuss the changes of POF and QRS complex in hypertrophy of atrium and ventricles. This is normal POF, in lead 2 and in V1 normal POF, that is biphasic. This initial part is formed by the right atrium and the terminal part is formed by the left atrium, because the right atrium is anterior to the left anatomically. But in right atrial hypertrophy, this initial part becomes more long, so POF is tall. In V1, initial part become prominent, but in left atrial hypertrophy the last part, that is terminal part, become prominent, so POF becomes bifid or M pattern. And in V1, lead V1, the last parts become prominent, so biphasic waves, negative wave is more prominent in biphasic part. So, in lead 2, tall POF is called right atrial hypertrophy or P pulmonale. And V1, initial part is more prominent in right atrial hypertrophy. And this is also called the P pulmonale. And in lead 2, bifid P or M pattern P indicates the left atrial hypertrophy or P mitrale. This P is bifid, but also this P is also wide, more wide. And in V1, the negative part of the biphasic POF is more prominent in left atrial hypertrophy, or this P also called P mitrale. Now I am going to discuss on ventricular hypertrophy. This is normal axis, that is wave 3. These 3 wave produce the S wave in V1 and R wave in V6. I have already mentioned it in first class. But in case of the left ventricular hypertrophy, this 3 wave becomes more prominent and this is oriented to the upwards. So left axis deviation occurs and S wave in V1 become more deep, R wave in V6 become more tall. So R wave in V5 or 6 plus S wave in V1 is more than 37 millimeter. Normally R wave in V6 and S wave in V1 is less than 37 millimeters. But in case of the left ventricular hypertrophy, R wave in V6 plus S wave in V1 is more than 37 millimeters. Normally R wave in V5 or 6 is less than 25 millimeter, but in case of the left ventricular hypertrophy, R wave in V5 or 6 is more than 25 millimeter, and in these cases left axis deviation occurs. In right ventricular hypertrophy, right ventricle is more thick than the left ventricle, so 3 wave is oriented to the right sides. These 3 wave produce the R wave in V1 and also R wave in V5 or 6. These R wave is more prominent. Normally in V1 R wave is less than the S wave, but in case of the right ventricular hypertrophy, R wave is greater than S. And when an V1 shows the R wave is greater than the S, it indicates right ventricular hypertrophy and also right axis deviation occurs.